Hey folks, how are you doing? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm the Tone Tony Viz. And here we are with part one of my, what I'm hoping is a regular Friday double feature here. I've watched SmackDown earlier. I'll get into that in my second video. But right now, I just want to recap Impact. Overall, I thought the show was good, but not quite as good as the last few weeks have been, mostly because of the AJ Dixie ridiculousness. But with that said, let's go right in. I thought all the matches were good, or from solid to good anyway. So let's go right into it. This show began with AJ and Dixie Carter backstage. Dixie saying that she's glad that they finally got the truth out. She's ready to move on, and AJ says he's gonna now he feels like the weight's been lifted off his shoulders, and he's gonna pound the crap out of Dana as a Kazarian. Okay. So then after the opening or whatever, then they show Dixie Carter with this chick who's apparently her name is Claire Lynch, and they were just walking around backstage, and they go into some like door or room or whatever. And then Mike Tenay mentions that we'll hear Claire's story about why she became an addict and everything throughout the rest of the night. Whoopity freaking doo dah. So we get to our first match, Bound for Glory series, Ken Anderson, RVD. RVD wins. Gets the pin for 7 points. It was a good match. He got the win with the crucifix roll-up. Then Austin Aries came out, and then they went to commercial break. We get back to the show, and then Austin Aries talked about how when he had a major decision to make last week when he was in the ring with Hulk Hogan, and he said it was a decision that would change TNA as a whole. And he said relinquishing the X Division belt wasn't easy for him. He says he's beaten everyone, he's beaten super heavyweights like Bubba Ray Dudley and Samoa Joe. And now he'd like to challenge for the World Heavyweight title. So he says that when Hogan agreed to Austin Aries' option C, that made it easier for him to give up the belt. And he mentions that there will be a tournament at Destination X to crown a new X Division champion. What's going to be, I'll get into that when that comes up. But he says that there's some old and new X guys out there, like every X Division guy will have the same chance every July that he's getting this year. And then Bobby Roode comes out, and he says that Aries sounds pathetically overconfident, which is right up his alley, just right up Austin Aries' alley. And Roode says that he is the real world champion, and his belt is the real world title because he made it that way. And he says that he made the belt the most important belt in the industry. He said he's the most dominant champion in Impact Wrestling, whatever you want to call it. And then Roode says, there are 12 guys, the guys in the Buffalo series, of course, clawing and scratching and fighting their way for a title shot at him, against him, the Bound for Glory. And he says, Austin Aries only got a chance to challenge him for the world title because of Hulk Hogan. And Roode says that option C is a failure, and he says that Austin Aries is setting himself and the X Division up for failure, and at Destination X, Roode will see that Aries flaps. And then he tells Aries that he isn't even in his league. He calls him kid and tells him to get out of his ring. And then Austin Aries says, "Wait a minute, what if this is my ring?" And if you want, if he wants to make him leave, he knocks the microphone out of Roode's hand and says that he should make him. Then they make like they're gonna go at it. Roode unbuttons his shirt, Aries rips his shirt off, and then Roode just walks out and saying it isn't worth his time. Really good segment. I thought they did a good job here, and that match at Destination X should be really good. Then we get to the first of the direct segments of the show. We have Claire and Dixie backstage being interviewed by the cameraman. Claire was saying that she met AJ through Dixie. The story, and the whole story, everything got bad because Aaron and Daniels found out about it. She said she'd never met them before this. She can't believe that they would do such a thing like blackmail them or whatever. Not much to it, really. It was a stupid segment, and the rest of them were just as ridiculous. Then we get to Kazarian and Daniels backstage, and Kazarian is really pissed at Daniels and saying that "What'd you make me do? You made me turn on my best friend, and I bought into all your crap and this and that." And then Daniels just walks out, and Daniels like, "We got a tag title match tonight." Stupid. So then we get to the X Division Championship Tournament match, first round, returning Sanjay Dutt versus Rubix, otherwise known as Jigsaw in Dragon Gate Evolved, Chikara, Ring of Honor, and all that stuff. Good match. Sanjay won. Sanjay got the pin, so he'll advance to Destination X, I believe. That'd be a good match. You know, Rubik's Jigsaw, I've seen a lot of his stuff. He is good in the ring. You know, I've seen him before. Really impressed with his stuff. And of course, Sanjay is really good, too. So hopefully he'll be back regularly. Then afterwards, Christy Hemme interviews Sanjay, asking how he feels to be back in the Impact Zone. You know, he says great, and he says, one thing he never accomplished in TNA before was winning the X title, and he says that Destination X, that's what he'll do. Good promo there. Then we have Bruce Pritchard, Al Snow, Taz, Gut Check, judges discussing Taylor Hendricks' fate in the office. That was the usual back and forth ridiculousness, you know. It's like they say that she has potential. Bruce Pritchard says she's too green. Taz mentions her being misdiagnosed and everything, and you know, and that make her humble but also hungry. Pritchard doesn't think she's got it. Taz thinks she does. Al Snow doesn't know yet. And that was it. Whatever. You know, these segments I'm not really into. These gut check segments. So then we go to next Battle for Glory series match, Samoa Joe vs. Bubba Dudley. Good match here. Joe won by submission. He got 10 more points out of it. What happened was Joseph Park came out, got up on the ring apron. Ray got in his face, he pulled him by the collar. And then Park slapped him. And then Samoa Joe locked down the Kikini Clutch and Ray tapped out. This was good too. This was a good match too. I thought they did some good stuff here. Then after the match, Joseph Park got the mic and says that, it's like, he knows who Ray is, but does Ray know who he is? He said that he's Joseph Park, and he says that Bubba Ray is nothing but a jackass bully. And then he mentions, he says that he was bullied his whole life, and even throughout law school, whatever. And he says, that ends now, whatever. And he says, this is no longer about his brother Abyss. He says that, it's like he's watched Ray bully everyone around long enough, and he's sick of it, and he knows the fans are sick of it, and he says that in 2 weeks, he'll fight Bubba Ray again. And this time, he's bringing the fight right to Bubba Ray. Really good promo. I really think that Chris Park is doing a phenomenal, no pun intended, great job playing with this character. It's really good. He's really, really nailed it down. He's really got it. Yeah, he really, he's really good at it. Let's say that way. So I'm going to go from that really great promo to more Drek on Dixie and Claire. We talked about how shocked they were that Daniels and Kazarian being such heels or whatever. Dixie mentions that, it's like she and AJ going into the hotel room, that video was to see Claire to celebrate her act getting cleaned up or whatever. She says the phone call with, Dixie says that the phone call with herself and AJ was actually, in fact, the plan. Serge's birthday party, and, the kids were going to come down or whatever. Cameraman asked if Claire was there for that. She said, no, she wasn't. Dixie said that Claire was having problems, and shitty segment. I didn't care. I don't know. Who do we have gives a rat, what about any of this? Stupid. Then we go to Kazarian in Hulk Hogan's office, and he's saying he made a mistake to falling for Daniel's BS. And he says that, he can't be tag champion with Daniel. He doesn't want to be in the match, blah, blah, blah. Hogan said that Kazarian knew what Daniel was doing, and that he was wrong, and that Kazarian's not the same guy or whatever, and Hulk tells him he booked the match, so he's got to be in there and see if, he's going to find out what Kazarian is made of tonight. Whatever, it was awful. They make Kazarian look like a real idiot here. So then we get Madison Rayne walking by Garrett Bischoff backstage. She tells him that she has this crush, and she asks him what he's like, and then he whispers to her who it is, or she whispers it to him, and he says good luck with that, and he walks off, and I guess she's got all this shot down look on her face, whatever. I mean, it's gonna be Garrett, So then we go to another awful segment backstage with the two Brooks, the Brookster and Brooke Tessmacher. Brookster saying that she got Miss Tessmacher onto the Direct Auto Insurance ad. Whoopity doo! Who gives a rat's ass? And then Gail Kim comes in and says that, Brooke Hogan needs to realize that the other knockouts are just cheap imitations of her. And then Brooke says that Gail Kim will get her rematch against Tessmacher for the knockouts title next week. Brooke Hogan segments are terrible. Less said about them, the better. Second of two X Division tournament matches for this week. Rashad Cameron, who's G's in the Urban Wrestling Federation, which I'm not familiar with, taking on Mason Andrews, who's Scorpio Sky, who I've heard of before, and this was my first time seeing him. Rashad G's Cameron got the win, you know, got the pinfall. I thought it was a good match, you know, mostly a lot of spots, but it was impressive. It was nice, you know, to finally see, you know, Scorpio Sky. I had heard his name mentioned many times, you know, so it was nice to finally see what he was doing there. Then afterwards, Chrissy asks Rashad how it feels to be going to Destination X. He said that everyone was looking at the next X Division champion, and everyone just saw the beginning of the Rashad Cameron movement. Decent promo, but the Rashad Cameron movement thing was a little hokey, I thought. So then we go to Hulk Hogan in his office with Jeff Hardy and James Storm. He just praises both guys pretty much, and then he just says that next week's Bound for Glory Series main event is going to be Jeff versus Storm. Okay, thankfully that was short. Then we get the gut check segment. You know, JB is in there with Bruce Allen Taz. You know, and then JB introduces Taylor Hendricks. And then they do some stuff. You know, Taz says he knows how he'll vote. JB asks Allen Pritchard if they're ready to vote, and they say they are. Taylor Hendricks says she's hungry for success. Taz votes first. He votes yes. Then Al Snow, his turn, said he's known Taylor for years and watched her perform. And before he can do anything, Joey Ryan sitting in the front row, and Taz gets out of the ring and gets in his face, and Joey Ryan just dares Taz to hit him, and then security comes in to take Joey Ryan out. It was really good. That was good stuff there, right there. So anyway, back to the gut check here. Back to, you know, Al Snow votes no, and then it's time for, you know, with the 1-1 tie, time for Taylor to cut a promo before Pritchard gives his deciding vote. So she says that someone, somewhere, each of the three judges were given a chance, and that's what she wants here, and she'll fight to prove that she can shine. So then it's Pritchard's turn. He says she's green and isn't sure if she has the mean streak in her or if she's ready for prime time, but he says that she has heart and a lot of class, unlike Joey Ryan. So he votes yes. So she gets the TNA contract. This actually wasn't as bad as the other two gut check segments. I thought, you know, the back and forth with Taz and Joey Ryan, I thought was really good. The segment itself wasn't bad either. I thought Taylor Hendricks cut a good promo there. Then we get Kurt Angle and AJ Styles backstage. Kurt Angle's telling AJ that everything with Dixie's finally over. Angle says that the AJ he knows is back. And, you know, then AJ mentions about how the weight's off his shoulders. And then AJ mentions that at Destination X, he'll face Daniel in a Last Man Standing match. And Angle mentions that their tag title match. He says that they're united and Kazarian and Daniels are divided, so this one's in the bag. Decent backstage segment. Time for the main event, which is the tag title match. And they show Dixie and Claire sitting in the front row. But anyway, thankfully nothing too stupid happened here. So then we get tag title match, champs Angle and AJ versus Kazarian and Daniels. What happens here, you know, Daniels throws Kurt Angle into the referee. He goes and he gets a chair. Most of the match, you know, Kazarian doesn't want to do anything, he's pretty much letting Daniels fight on his own. So then, you know, Daniels gets a chair, he's going to hit Styles with it, Kazarian takes it out of his hands, then AJ was going to go for the Styles Clash on Daniels, but then Kazarian hit AJ in the back with a chair. So he turned out that whole thing was just a ruse after all. So then Daniels pin AJ, ref comes to, 1-2-3, Kazarian and Daniels regain the tag titles. Then afterwards, Daniels says it's a great day because they've regained the tag titles, and then he turns to Dixie and says that, you know, just Claire, whatever, that, you know, didn't tell her the whole truth. You know, Daniels mentions that Claire's pregnant, and the father is none other than AJ Styles. And that was the show. Like I said, you know, good match, stupid ending, you know, I mean, this whole storyline with Claire the pregnant crack whore is stupid. Now AJ is the phenomenal dad or whatever, I don't know what the fuck they're doing. So anyway, like I said, I thought this week's show was a little bit of a step down from the last few impacts, but I thought it was still solid. You know, Ares and Rude had a good promo at the beginning, the tag title match was good, you know, the Dixie Claire stuff was awful. The Balls Deep Butcher Hogan Brooke Test Market Kim segment sucked. Joseph Park's promo was really good. He's doing a great job with that. And Taz and Joey Ryan, you know, that was good too. The gut check segment with Taylor Hendricks was, I thought was decent. It was cool to see Sanjay Dutt back too. So overall, I thought this week was, well, not quite as good as the last few weeks, mainly because of the AJ Dixie and all that shit. I think that brought it down a few steps. But I still thought it was a solid show. So that'll do it for me right now with part one of my Friday double feature. And I'll be back in just a few minutes with my SmackDown post-game show. So I'm the Tony Viz. Be back with my SmackDown post-video in a few minutes.